Hi, this is Pattu from FreeFinCal, and in this video, let's discuss 6 money resolutions that you can consider making for 2019. Today is December 1st, 2018, and this is the perfect time to start on this resolution so that by January 1st, 2019, it will become a habit and you know what you exactly have to do. I wrote an article about this for Diwali last month. I think it's still valid for this month since it's for 2019. So, the first one, I think everybody should decide to work towards a second source of income. You may be working in a desk job today, you may be in a cubicle, you may be working for somebody else, you may be doing things that you do not like, but I think you should sit down and think about your skills and talents, and you should find out what skills and talent of yours will people find useful and pay for, and that can become your second source of income. There's no hurry to start generating the second source of income. You can build on this gradually. You can have a 5-year plan, 10-year plan, 15-year plan, and so that by the time you are close to financial freedom, this secondary source of income will step in and handle most of your expenses. When I say secondary source of income, I do not mean passive income. There's no such thing as passive income. You have to actively work for whatever income. It does not need to be a website. It need not be affiliate marketing or internet marketing or a YouTube channel or whatever. It can be anything. It can be just like teaching music to somebody or teaching tuition classes to your neighborhood children and so on. Anything that's your second source of income. Just think about what you can, what talent and skill of yours can you use to get a second source of income, and plan, have a plan, and slowly, gradually work toward that consistently, and I'm sure it'll help you. The second resolution is from 2019 onwards, you should resolve that whatever happens, unless it's some life-threatening emergency, for normal emergencies like washing machine breaking down or TV breaking down or motorbike breaking down, for such normal emergencies, you will not redeem from your investments for long-term goals. So in order to do that, you should start contributing 5 to 10% of your monthly income in an emergency fund. Your emergency fund can be a separate state bank account other than your salary account. It can be a flexi deposit account, that is an SB account plus fixed deposit together, a flexi deposit sweep account, sweep in account, I think that's what they call it in banks. You can use that, you can use a liquid mutual fund, you can use an arbitrage mutual fund, you can do, there are so many ways to do it. You can have a credit card also for emergencies, but use it only for emergencies. Don't worry about all these reward points, etc., and so on. They are useless. So that's the idea. So work towards your emergencies. So the third thing is you should understand the importance of inflation in your life. So the standard example that I give in my talks is that in 1990, the cost of a cup of cutting chai on the street would be like 50 paisa or 1 rupee. Today it's like 10 rupees, anywhere between 7 rupees to 10 rupees. That's like a year-on-year inflation of about 10 to 12%. So if that's how your expenses are inflating. So unless your portfolio, the total portfolio, including equity and fixed income, the total portfolio return after paying all taxes should be at least 10%. So list your long-term goals, find out how much you need to invest for them. You don't need to do too much work about this. I have the robo-advisory tool. You can just download it from this link and work on your goals. It'll just do this weekend. That's all it will take. The other thing is, sometimes when you use these financial goal calculators, the amount of money that you need to invest for your goals will be too much. It'll be too depressing sometimes, but don't worry about it. Whatever you can invest, start investing. And what you must decide is, from 2019 onwards, you will increase your monthly investment every year by 5 to 10% year on year. It will not be always easy. Initially, it will be easy, but after 5-10 years, it'll be very difficult. For example, I have been doing this for almost 8-9 years now, and I'm finding it a little difficult because the amount, the 5-10% amount increase is a little bit higher. But do it. Try as much as you can. And whatever you do, when you want to take on any kind of debt, think real hard about it, because any debt that you take in your life will have repercussions on your cash flow. Either it will have it now or later. For example, if you buy a home, if you take using a home loan too soon in your life, then you may not be able to invest enough for retirement and your financial freedom will suffer. Buying a car loan, some people take second home loan, etc. So these kind of things, be careful, think real hard. My suggestion is to first of all decide on your goals, start investing for them, streamline that process of investing for your goals, and then you can start taking on debt. If you take on debt too early in life, it might be a little difficult for you, unless of course you are super confident that you are skilled enough, talented enough, educated enough for your income to grow super duper high in 5 years, 10 years, and so on. Then it's a little bit okay. But other than that, for most normal people, average people, I think you have to be very, very careful about taking on any kind of debt. So just think about all. I'm not saying don't buy a home, don't buy a car. I'm not saying all that. I'm just saying before you take on debt, think about the implications that it will have on the money needed for your goals. How it will affect that, and can you make up for it later in life? That is what you need to think. Many people don't do that. And lastly, this is probably more important in 2019 or maybe today itself, from today itself, go on an information diet. Seek information only if you have a specific need. Do not simply go to my website or my YouTube channel or anybody's website or Twitter or social media. Do not go and simply, graze around for information. Unless you have a clear need with respect to investing and money management, do not look for information. If you have a clear need, go to Google and type that clear need, and Google will tell you. The machine learning capabilities of Google is astounding. It is becoming intelligent more and more every day, and it is more intelligent than many people that you will see in a personal finance forum. So if you have a clear need, and if you define that need to Google and read the first 5 pages that comes, and you should be able to get yourself an opinion about what you need. So please do not seek out information without any need. Do it only when it is necessary. That's what I call as an information diet. So work on these resolutions right from today, and by January 1st, 2019, you will be in better shape and this will become a habit, and you'll feel much more comfortable about where you stand with respect to money management. A couple of things. I've received several comments about the videos that I make, I've received questions about which fund should I choose, what should I do for my, I'm like so and so years, my father is this much, and so on. I cannot answer personalized questions like that. I can answer and get more viewers and so on, but it's irresponsible for me to hand out free lunch without understanding your personal needs. So I will not do that. Please do not ask me which one should I choose, etc. and so on. And I have also received questions, I've also received suggestions to speak in Hindi, make videos on Hindi. Unfortunately, Hindi अच्छी तरह समझ सकता हूँ, लेकिन पूछने में तो बहुत ही कठिनाई होती है. मैंने हिंदी हम लोग बुनियाद रामायण महाभारत देखकर सीखा था. Also, I studied Hindi from 6th standard to 8th standard only. So मैं Madrasi हूँ. So I have that. I'm a little. I can speak. To some extent, but I get awkward and very conscious of myself when I do that. So I don't think I can make videos in Hindi. So, but I'm glad that you asked. So that's it. Have a good weekend, and I'll catch you in another video. Bye bye.